Newsman, you awake?
I'm heading to that camp you spotted north of the mountain.
I heard gunshots. It might be an ambush camp.
Find out when I get there. Deacon out.
I swear I... something.
Booze man, you were right. They set up along the railroad tracks.
Kill every one of those sons of bitches.
That was kind of the plan. Deacon out.
No! My leg! Oh, God! No!
That's the last of them. Stay the hell off O'Leary Mountain.
Boozer, it's done. Squatter camp. They won't be doing any more killing on O'Leary Mountain.
Good. Deke, I should have been there. To help, I mean, I...
Shit. Just rest up, Booze Man. Rest up. We're riding north as soon as your arm heals. You got that?
Yeah, I hear you. Boozer out.
Yeah, I'm gonna ride up to the cemetery and see if I can find Leon's stash.
Sorry. What was that?
Rest up, Boozer. We're heading north as soon as you can ride.
North. Yeah.
Booze Man, no. You know I wouldn't write news about you.
Yeah, I know. I just kinda out of it.
Well, third degree burns will do that to you.
Yeah. So, take care of Alvarez, you know. Deke, it means a lot to me.
Ow.
Who's man? No.
You know, I wouldn't.
Yeah, I know. I just kind of out of it.
Well, third degree burns will do that to you.
Hey, man. So, take care of Alvarez, you know. Think. Means a lot to me.
Take care of her, loser. Just get some rest.
Deacon out. Now I might be able to catch up to him.
I want him alive, Deke.
Alive?
Alive. You catch this man, then radio me. We'll fetch him and hang the bastard right from that limb. It's time we start showing these drifter sons of bitches that we have law and order in this camp. No offense meant to yourself.
None taken. I'll find him. Radio Free Oregon is on the air once again. Oh, Jesus, what have I done? some new things. Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon? Where? Maybe in one of these. Got it. I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? You're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me. It acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid. Yeah.
Ian.
Hold on, hold on. They're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
See something? Stop!
Hold on.
Right there!
We could be friends now, can't we?
Stop! Yeah, I don't want to. We're entering a quarantined area.
Rock, that ought to distract them.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at.
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No. So, Ryan.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
King O'Brien.
Didn't you hear me? Over 400 subjects. And these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
But they're slapping like this, Sarah. No.
And I asked if you were going in. I didn't say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was fubar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
Think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
See the caves. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
We brought in a farewell. The Nero guy, the soldier, he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you...
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. He wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
He's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Don't.
Not! Loser, I'm not. This is... This was... Get out.
Later, to burn out these nests.
This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they'd have blown it to hell. Just so we wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit, Radio Free Oregon. Bunch of murderers and vagrants. Would just as soon shoot you as look at you.
Who's out there?
Yeah.
Sniper ambush, oh goddammit.
killed him!
Use this. Let's see. Bounties.
You're gonna be okay. Hey, hey, it's not safe out here in the shit. I know where there's a camp that...
camp? Yeah, where? Yeah, yeah. I'll go.
Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
Thank you.
Tell him it was St. John. Deacon. They know that.
Stay off the main roads. Don't stop.
St. John, this is Copeland. Hmm. I haven't seen Boozer in a few days. Hmm. He used to do runs for me, is all. I know you ride with him. Tried to radio him, can't seem to reach him. Well, you see him, you tell him to swing by and say hello to Cope. I would much appreciate it. Copeland out.
Boozer, you there?
Yeah, Deke.
I took care of it. Alvarez, I mean.
Thanks, brother. She do the same for us.
Yeah, she would have. Deacon out.
The cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving, because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they would have blown it to hell. Just so I wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit Radio Free Oregon.
mass grave. Why'd they bury this shit out here again? Oh, yeah, because they're assholes. Off figures. How the hell do I get in there?
Hey, Deke, you there? I was thinking about heading down to that logging camp, clear out those nests. I'd see more freaks up here.
Boozer, no! No, you're gonna get yourself killed. You gotta wait till you're whole, brother. I'm over here anyway, so...
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know